Hi all my YouTube family and friends, Jewel here with you with the J7409 weather forecast for tomorrow, Tuesday, and going into a little of Wednesday morning. We do have a clipper system right here coming in. This is midnight tonight for Tuesday, midnight right here. You can see Monday midnight, Tuesday morning early. We are going to have a mix with some ice and some snow up here right around these areas of Wisconsin. And as you can see, moving over here into portions of Illinois with some rain out west. We got another clipper system coming in. It's going to bring a lot of heavy rain down in California. I know you guys have been flooded out in the past day, week or so, and looks like you're going to get some more coming in. Everybody else looking pretty dry right now. Let's let this loop through. It'll go through midnight Thursday. And it does look like much of the country is going to stay dry over the next couple of days. That's because we got a broad upper level ridging shift from the western to the central part of the country. With the exception of that clipper I just showed you like system dropping southeastward from the Midwest and to the southeast with light to moderate rain and snow showers. Snow showers could be some, could be just a little bit of ice. The snow and stuff, it shouldn't amount to a whole lot. And it's going to spread from the Great Lakes tonight into the Ohio Valley and Appalachians during the day, Tuesday, tomorrow. Now, once again, little to no snow accumulations are anticipated outside of higher elevations of the central and southern Appalachians, where you guys, once again, listen up, okay? The central and southern Appalachians, you could get a couple of inches or so. That's going to be possible for you. And rain's coming, yes, for the Carolinas. Showers are going to increase by Wednesday with the potential of coastal areas seeing some locally heavy showers enhanced by a coastal low. And it's developing off the Atlantic coast. Now we got a broad upper level ridge, and that's going to keep temperatures well above the January averages. And I'm going to show you all about that coming up. Just in a moment, we'll just check out temperatures. But then we do have some light to moderate showers. The forecast looking like they're going to come up for portions of the coastal Pacific Northwest through Tuesday, and a series of Pacific waves pass by the region at that time. Attention will then turn to the nasty old atmospheric river. It's expected to begin to bring impacts to the west coast as early as tomorrow evening, Tuesday evening, and ramping up through the day for Wednesday. Now, a combination of these strong dynamic forces as well as deep anomaly high stream of moisture moving into southwestern Oregon and northern California. It's going to lead to very heavy rainfall for you guys with totals of several inches. And the warm air will keep snow levels kind of high at first, allowing for heavy rainfall along the upslope portions of the coastal ranges and Sierra Nevada. Now, you're going to have an excessive rainfall amount too, okay? Also, strong gusty winds up to 65 miles per hour are also expected for portions of southwestern Oregon and Northern California beginning late Tuesday night. So please keep that in mind and be prepared. 65 mile per hour winds, they get, you know, how they're going to blow things around. And if you're out traveling, please stay safe. I said we're going to look at the temperature, so let's do so, okay? This is a great graph that shows you really good information and accurate information. Here we go. Tuesday, 7 a.m. for the weather, but let's hop down to the temperatures. Tomorrow morning, okay, you can see up in Maine, you guys are going to be below zero, especially in the northern and central sections of Maine. You're going to be anywhere from maybe 0 to below 0 in places, and then maybe 10 to 0 in other places. And as you move down the East Coast, you can see the temperatures moderate, like in portions of Massachusetts, Connecticut, New England, northern New Jersey, portions of Pennsylvania, 20s. Going to be chilly, 20s. And as you move a little further down the coastline, you can see a lot of Virginia is going to be in the 20s. And North Carolina, the Appalachians in Virginia and North Carolina, and in eastern Tennessee, you're going to be in the 20s. You might hit some 30s, but looking like 20s is what you can look forward to. For the Carolinas, looking like, well, it's going to be freezing, okay? 32 to 30 degrees all the way down to the panhandle of Florida. A lot of Florida. You got to get down around Miami before you get up to hitting the 50 degree mark. So, going to be chilly. You can see, though, looking at the United States out west, it's extremely warm come tomorrow morning around 7 a.m. Look at these temperatures. You got 50 degrees, California, and also western Oregon, western Washington State. Now, as we move over to 10 a.m., you can see how the temperatures are going to change, but all of Maine is going to be very, very cold at 10 o'clock tomorrow. And at 1 p.m., you can see it starts to moderate a little bit in Maine, but Maine in the northern and central sections still staying very cold, but still very, very warm. 60 degrees in places in California, moving down to Arizona, Texas, Louisiana, Florida. You're going to warm up tomorrow. Look at that. And at 4 p.m., it gets even warmer. So warmer temperatures for all of the people that you see here I've talked about, and the cooler temperatures for all of the people I've talked about up in the Northeast, especially Maine, okay? But so far as it looks like tomorrow night's temperatures will be, just about like tonight's temperatures are going to be just about the same for nighttime lows. As you can see right here on the map, we got 40s in western Tennessee. Look over in California, still staying warm. 4 a.m. in the morning over in the western section of the state, from Washington State, western Oregon, and in California. At 4 a.m. in the morning, Tuesday, or I should say, Tuesday, wee hours of Tuesday morning at 4 a.m. Look, you're still going to be in the 50s at this mark. Wind gust Tuesday night, looking kind of breezy everywhere. But let's go back to Tuesday, tomorrow itself, and check out the wind speed. You can see on the coastal sections right offshore, looking like we're going to have some pretty good gusts, but you can see over the system coming in from the west, moving over towards Northern California, Oregon, and Washington State. The wind is going to pick up drastically, as you can see, just like I was telling you about. And the weather in the morning, well, portions of Wisconsin up around the Great Lakes, moving down in portions of Iowa, all you guys expect a little bit of snow mixed in with some ice. Shouldn't be a whole lot of ice, but you could have a little bit, so be aware of that, and a little bit of snow. And once again, at 10 a.m., you can see it's going to start moving on across, and the rain's going to start to pick up. You got some mix by 1 in the afternoon over in Ohio, and a little bit of ice in portions and up around the Great Lakes area. Mostly it looks like a mix, though, and I think you're going to have some rain into this, okay? That's what it's looking like. And by 4 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, Ohio, you've got a little bit of rain, you've got some mix, and it's a little heavier in the central sections of Ohio and then it's a little lighter on the east and the western sections. And some of this mix will be in Indiana, Michigan, up around the Great Lakes, as you can see. That's what it's looking like, folks. Take care, stay safe, stay warm if you're on the cold side. Enjoy the warmth on the western side. Everybody have a good evening, a safe evening, and a blessed evening. Thank you so much for watching. I love you all, and I thank you for everything you do. Have a great one. Thanks for watching.